We want to find the value of the Riemann sum given here for f of x equals x squared plus 1 using the partitions p equals 1, 2, 4, and 7, where c sub k, the input into the function, is the right endpoint of each partition. So because our function is non-negative over this interval, we can think of this as determining the area of rectangles to approximate the area under this curve. But if the function was below the x-axis, it wouldn't give us the area, but the process would be the same. Looking at our summation here, notice how we have f of c times delta x. Again, because our function is non-negative, we can think of f of c as being the y value, or the height of each rectangle, and delta x as being the width of each rectangle. Let's begin by forming our partitions using 1, 2, 4, and 7. Here's x equals 1, here's x equals 2, here's x equals 4, and here's x equals 7. Notice how using these four values, we have three partitions. The first partition has a width of 1 unit, which would be delta x. The second partition has a width of 2 units, which would be delta x. The third partition has a width of 3 units, which again would be delta x. And now we can form our rectangles using the right side, or right endpoint, of each partition. So sketching the rectangles for this first interval, this would be the rectangle. The second partition, the right side, or this side here, would be the height, the width of 2 units. The third partition, this would be the height, or the function value, and the width would be 3 units. So again, because our function is non-negative, this Riemann sum will be the sum of the three areas of the three rectangles. So if the function did drop below the x-axis, we may have a rectangle that's partially below the x-axis, and therefore the value may be negative. Let's go ahead and set this up using function notation, and then we'll find the value. Starting with this first rectangle, again, the height would be f of 2, and then delta x, the width, would be 1 unit, plus the next height would be f of 4 times delta x, the width of 2 units. And finally, the third rectangle has a height of f of 7 with a width, or delta x, of 3 units. Now we'll determine these function values using f of x equals x squared plus 1. So f of 2 would be 2 squared plus 1, or 5. So we have 5 times 1, plus f of 4 would be 4 squared plus 1, or 16 plus 1, or 17, times 2, plus f of 7, that'd be 7 squared plus 1, or 49 plus 1, that's 50, times 3. So the value of this Riemann sum would be 5 plus 34 plus 150, or 189. I hope you found this helpful.